It's the real winner of the most recent Patreon Mega Votathon extravaganza. We finally made it. The Wait by the band. Sorry for the wait. Speaking of Patreon, if you don't mind, I'd like to take just a moment to thank the following people for signing up for the Patreon supporter of the cause club, MD Tubio, Michael Beck, and James Pollock. Folks, thank you for your support. And if you would like to find out what that's all about, the link, of course, is in the description. And I made you a tab. It is free, 100%, no strings attached. Go get it, RyanLent.com. Show notes, but there is one teeny tiny thing to mention. The title is in super secret backwards code, so no ne'er-do-wells can horn in on our secret information. The opposite of the wait is, of course, helium balloons. For the intro, this is the main reason why I wanted to make you a tab. Grab the D string on the 9th fret and hammer up to 11. You may notice, if you're following along with the tab, that there's a 9 on that G string as well, and that's because you kind of want a sloppy, shimmery get it when you strike that D string as well. Right? So 9 to 11 on the D string, and then to 9-9 on the G and B strings. Now, similarly, we're going to go from 9 to 11 on the G string, but when you get there, leave it and add the B string 10th fret. Then 9-11-9 on the G string, 9-11 on the D string, slide down 2 frets. So there's our first line. Here we go. Let's see if I can do it. Then you're going to grab those D and G strings in the 7th fret now, and the D string is going to hammer up to 9 twice before falling back down to 7-7. Then your pinky finger grabs the B string all the way up on the 10th fret, and your pointer finger is going to bar all the way from A to G. Give that a strum. One more strum and hammer that A string up to 9 with your ring finger. Back to regular, grab E9, and give it a glissando, or as they say in the old country, a boom, down to here, and hit A. And when you're on A, you hang there a bit. You can sus for it if you want. That's the B string 3rd fret. But here is the second half of the intro. Here is the second half of the intro. Don't worry, that was the hard part. The verse is just A, C sharp minor. If you know B minor, you know C sharp minor because it's B minor, but 2 frets higher. If you don't know B minor, C sharp minor is A4, D, G, 6, B5, and to D, and A. That's our whole verse. A, C sharp minor. Forget that it starts on A and ends on A, so it's gonna feel like you're doing A twice every time except the first time. A, C sharp minor, D, A. You gotta feel that last chord, first chord. Last chord, right? For the chorus, the take a load off part, we're gonna play A, E, D. 3 times. The third time we arrive at D, you hang there, but you throw in a quick D sus 2 before you let it ring out. That just means take your middle finger off before they go. Right on, right on, right on. You may be noticing that the bass does not play E with you when you play E in the chorus. The bass plays G sharp. Well, when you're playing E, you are playing some notes, one of which is G sharp. There it is on the G string, 1st fret. So the bass is allowed to play G sharp. So that's why you hear more of in the chorus than. But I watched that really lovely live version with those really nice ladies singing along with the band, and they unequivocally, they were in a different key, but adjusted for the key that we're in for the studio recording, they were unequivocally playing E and not some crazy A with a G sharp. Or, you know, you could even play E with a G sharp in the bass if you really wanted to, but that is not a quick get to it chord, so I would recommend just the E. G-sharp nonsense notwithstanding, after the chorus we've got that little instrumental bit, and it really accentuates that downward walk. And to differentiate between the chorus part and this chorus, I am going to play an A with a G-sharp in the bass. This is technically an A major 7 with a G-sharp in the bass. All you do is play one finger A, and then you reach with probably your ring finger to the E string 4th fret before proceeding on to F sharp minor. That is 2, 4, 4 to E and D. If you hate this idea, play E. That works too. So you'll either have A, G sharp in the bass, F sharp minor, E, D. Or A, E, F sharp minor, E. That is all I have to say about that. Patreon folks, thank you so much for your great ideas and thanks for your participation. It's time to start a new round. Everybody else, thank you so much for being here. I hope that was fun and helpful, and I will see you next time with more stuff. Goodbye.